You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, August 10th, 2020. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are moving on to the ninth commandment, which is, thou shalt not covet your neighbor's wife. Now, this might be a little bit more of an adult commandment. It has to do with remaining pure, with respecting the sacrament of marriage. But there are many things that all people of all ages can understand from this commandment. Now, here is the basic thing that we all need to understand and remember each time we meet a new person or interact with someone that we see every day. Each and every person on this earth is a wonderful, remarkable, and unique creation of God. Also, each person is truly a temple of the Holy Spirit, where God Himself dwells. Therefore, we need to have the utmost respect for each person. We should never see that person as an object. Covet means to desire or to want. Sometimes we want people so that they can be used for a certain thing or they can do something for us. And we should never covet or want to possess someone else because they are a temple of the Holy Spirit, because we know God, we love God, and we know that we could never possess God. Now, this commandment also makes it clear that we all will face sin at some times. And the big thing to remember here is that during moments of temptation, there are also moments when we can turn to prayer. And the prayer that we should turn to is, Lord, reveal to me this entire person. Lord, reveal to me this entire person. Because it is when we realize all of the details about someone, we don't just fixate on something we really like about them or something we really hate about them, but we see the whole person, that we can become better in touch with how wonderfully they are created, how God is working within them, just as He is working within me. Now, this is something that we will continue to learn and relearn our whole life, that there is a lot to each person. Each person is a deep mystery. Each person has an incredible story, and God ministers to each person in a unique and wonderful way. So this week, each day of the week, we actually have a really wonderful saint celebrating a feast day. Today is the feast day of St. Lawrence. And all week long, we're going to talk about these incredible saints, and we are going to work to get to know them a little bit better. Because the problem sometimes with being a saint in the Catholic Church is that we can assume that these people, they're boring, they're old, they don't understand the problems that we're going through. We can make those very wrong assumptions. But as you will see, just from the saints celebrating feast days this week, that saints come from all different walks of life. The saints had many of the same struggles that we have, and that we can learn a lot directly from these people. So first of all, St. Lawrence. Now, St. Lawrence did live a long time ago. He lived during the 200s, and he lived while it was still a crime to be a Christian. He lived in Rome, where the Christians had moved their headquarters, and he was one of seven deacons in Rome who was charged with caring for the poor. So he gathered money and distributed it to the poor. Now, there was a great persecution for Christians going on. The bishop which he served was martyred. And as he was martyred, the bishop said to Lawrence, don't worry, you will come and join me in martyrdom in 3 days. Now, after the bishop had been killed, the prefect, who was an officer in Rome, well, he turned to Lawrence. He thought wrongly, of course, that the Christians were very rich and that they gathered all of this wealth to keep for themselves. So he turned to Lawrence and said, In 3 days, you will return here with all of the wealth of the Christians. So St. Lawrence went. And knowing that he too would be martyred soon, he gave away all of the money that the church had. He even gave away his own personal possessions, and he had nothing. And yet he knew that this officer had commanded him to bring the wealth of the Christians to the Roman officers. So, since St. Lawrence was kind of a trickster, he went and he gathered up all of the poor people that he could find. And at the appointed time, he returned to the Roman officer and said, "Here, I have brought the riches of Christianity, because it is in the people of God who have become the body of Christ that we know true riches." So that riches can be found in people, not in possessions. Well, we might think that this was a very clever thing to do, but the Roman officers didn't really appreciate it. In fact, they were very angry, and because of this, they sentenced St. Lawrence to a slow and painful death. St. Lawrence was martyred by being grilled. They tied him to a grill and put a low, hot fire underneath it so that he was slowly burned to death. And yet God came to St. Lawrence and gave him the grace and courage that even while this was happening, he was able to yell out to the soldiers, "Turn me over, I'm done on this side." Still, St. Lawrence was martyred, but from the moment of his death, he was seen to be a martyr, a great man of faith who gave his life for love of Jesus Christ, and he continues to be a powerful intercessor today. Now, I hope that through the story of St. Lawrence, you can see, like the Roman officers, that we often judge people incorrectly, and we can be led to do some pretty terrible things when we do that. So pray through the intercession of St. Lawrence today, my friends, that you can be boldly who you are, that you can be brave and even face real evil, knowing that God is with you, just as God was with St. Lawrence.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing. We'd like to invite you to come and check out The Creed, which is a series for parents and children to use in the home during this uncertain time in the fall. It is an in-depth look at all that we believe, which we profess in the Nicene Creed each Sunday at Mass. It is made for the whole family, has some fun printables to go along with it, will be very easy to use no matter which point you are with your own faith. And it is on sale right now for just $7 for the whole bundle, which will take you from September all the way up into Advent. So check the notes for this podcast episode for the direct link to find more details.